Okay, just waiting for the other guy to finish up here, and I'll be off in just a second.
Yeah, Boss Falcon, stand by.
And Charlie, clear to back taxi runway 16.
Back taxi, and what I'd like to do is work the PA Freak Victor 12315, and I can monitor 2529 uniform.
You can do that. Let me know when you want to go to Street 2315.
Okay, that's where I'll meet Larry for the PA, correct?
Roger that.
I'm going 2350 now. He will clear me to take off?
I'll let him clear you for takeoff right now. He's doing the commentary in James 260, so as soon as he comes up 2315, you'll be live.
Okay, I'm coming up 2315. I am his Freak Victor, your Freak Uniform.
Gotcha.
If I can go to the cockpit and talk to Lieutenant Colonel Tom McLaughlin, call sign Turtle. Turtle, how do you read?
Hi, Larry, loud and clear. Getting ready to get turned around here, take off on runway 16. I'll have a takeoff roll this afternoon of, I think around 1,200 feet or so. And then I plan on staying with the airplane on its tail and getting it up to about 7,000 feet in about a 70 degrees nose high climb. And let me take this opportunity to say what an honor and a privilege it is to be back here among my Rhode Island friends.
Okay, I understand you're a local boy, is that right?
One of Pawtucket's finest.
I thought I'd get you to say that, Turtle. Well, we read you loud and clear. We're looking forward to an exciting performance, and I'm going to leave the channel open. You can talk to us whenever you feel like it during that time.
Very well. Feel free to pop questions as you see fit. Turning around right now, we'll be rolling here in just a few seconds.
Okay, Turtle, have a safe one. We're going to be looking forward to it.
Roger. Okay, checking my engines now, and that looks good. The flight controls are working. Rolling, hack the clock. Engine looks good. Selecting the afterburner. Burner is lighting up. Off the peg, there's 100 knots. 140 knots, airborne. I was afraid this is going to happen. I've lost sight of the airport.
That looked beautiful, Turtle. In a maneuver, every functional check pilot performs every afternoon, right?
Oh, yeah. This happens all the time. Let's see. I think I'm down by Block Island someplace. Well, there's the...
Altitude.
Here's the East Pass from Narragansett Bay. Let's see if we can find our way back.
Okay, that's why they invented INS, so we'll look for you in a few minutes.
Well, it's a Mount Hope Bridge. Prudence Island. There's Newport. No, can anybody see me? Where's the F-16?
Can't find you anywhere, Tom. We're looking for you.
Oh, there he goes.
Oop, there he is.
Okay, working our way up toward Greenwich Bay up here. We're going to bend the airplane around from north to south, and there'll be a good photo opportunity for those of you with cameras.
It looked like you had about 450 knots or so as you came by us.
Just about. And it's about 4 G's getting lined up again.
I'll have to, if that was only 4 G's, I'll have to give you a call during the 9 G turn.
Yeah, that's always a fun time. Okay, coming up from your left, and we'll bend it around the crowd.
Beautiful view as he makes his photo pass. Take the speed, Tom, what you have?
Just about 400 now, about 450 miles an hour. Okay, we're going to slow down a bit, configure the airplane, and come by with the gear and the flaps hanging.
Tom, going to come by in your high-speed pass at this time. What sort of speed are we looking for?
Well, actually, I'm coming by dirty this time. We're doing about 145 knots over the runway.
Oh, sorry about that. Okay, I'll read the script the next time. Going to come by in the high alpha pass.
Slowing it down to a landing speed of around 160 miles an hour, going through 200 now. The gear is down and the flaps are down. Checking the fuel, everything looks good. I'm gonna come back around and give you folks another photo opportunity on the knife edge.
Edge pass this time, Tom.
Well, we're going through about 300 knots, around 340 miles an hour. We'll get about 360 or so. Put it up on the side, roll it on over, let you see the top of the airplane. Come back around again. We'll do a high-speed pass to a vertical climb, getting it up to we're going to look at all about 10,000 feet.
Okay, well, we don't have a stopwatch here to time you, but I know that that aircraft has held some time to climb records. You'll probably get up to 10,000 feet in a very, very fast short of time. How much speed are we looking for when you come by, Tom?
Oh, I'm hoping to get it up to about 500 knots or so.
500 knots. We'll do the multiplication here.
Okay, there's 490, 500, 0.77 Mach. Up we go!
$3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $8,000, $9,000, and there's your 10. Outstanding, Tom, that's beautiful. You're getting a great round of applause down here, my friend.
Well, I'm glad they're enjoying it. Setting up the simulated flameout pattern.
Tell us about this flameout pattern. You're going to simulate that you actually lost the engine, and still you're going to be able to glide. You're going to be able to dead stick a Mach 2 fighter to a landing?
That's correct. What we do is we set up so that we start spiraling on down if we have our choices at about 7,000 feet above the runway or at certain distances depending on the energy state that we have. So I'm going to configure the airplane here, and I'll be coming at a high key at 7,000 feet from your left to your right.
Approximately how far offset from the side of the runway will you be at 7,000 feet so that you make this 360 and put it right on the runway?
Well, I'm right over the top of the runway right now, about a third of the way down. I've configured the airplane, and I'm at a left turn now going through east. I'm looking for a low-key altitude of approximately, 3,000 or 4,000 feet, and I'll adjust the energy I'm maintaining depending on the altitude and the speeds to try to cross over the runway threshold with good landing speed.
Outstanding. We're watching, Tom, and I'll tell the folks about it.
Turning onto a base leg now, carrying about 200 knots or so, about 220 miles an hour, and it looks like we would have been able to land out of this had we needed to.
It looks absolutely beautiful. We'll expect to go around right now.
On the go. Gonna head down south here for just a bit, get a little maneuvering speed, come on back, and we'll do a 9G turn. I'll be entering from your right and doing the 9G turn now about 1,500 feet or so east of you. Information sheet there, but you might want to tell the folks that in air-to-air combat, the F-16 has a record of 64 victories and zero defeats.
Standing, Tom, and obviously you have that same record or you wouldn't be here today.
No defeats. Okay, we're going to enter this at about 400 knots or so. That's 360, 370, 380, entering the 9G turn. This hurts.
Talk to me, Tom.
Not yet.
Bingo. Bingo.
Tomato that came by that time. Woo!
One-ton tomato. It always feels good when you stop doing that.
Banging your head against the wall. Feels good when you stop, huh?
Yes, sirree. Okay, I'm going to come down initial and pitch out like we normally would to recover in a VFR, a visual flight rule kind of day. Then I'm going to do a close pattern to a full stop, and we'll taxi on in and we'll say hi at you.
Okay, we're looking good. Thanks, Tom.
We normally approach and land the airplanes on good visual days like today. We find that it's tactically sound and we can get more airplanes in the pattern, and thus we don't string them back up all the way to Providence. Pitching out, extending the speed brake, slowing the aircraft down. Landing gear is coming down. Flaps come down automatically with the landing gear in this airplane. Checking to make sure the three wheels are indicating good, the hydraulics are up, setting the speeds, putting the speed brakes out, rolling off the perch for the low approach. That'll be followed by a closed full stop. starting the power in. Gears coming up at the end of the runway. I'll pull back up, or maybe a little shorter than that. Get reconfigured again, and we'll stop the airplane.
Outstanding.
Once again, configuring, checking the hydraulics are up, speed brakes are out, power set, and rolling off the perch.
Steady up on uniform.
Tom, looks like you're all set up for the full stop landing.
That's affirmative. Touching down in about 10 seconds, you'll see me raise the nose to aerodynamically brake the airplane.
Turtle show, boss.
No.
Hey, make a right turn on Alpha 2, stand off 5.3, your choice.
Alpha 2 and taxi in front of the Blue Angels?
Keep breath.
Okay.
Nice show, Turtle.
Thank you very much.
Tom, you won't hear them, but they're going to be waving at you. Let's give them a wave back.
Roger that. An absolute privilege and a pleasure to show you people your airplanes.